kitchen. Hit that PayPal account, yo. Give us a buck. 3332. Give us a buck so we can keeping it a buck.
You ain't never lied.
Brother man.
Brother man.
Oh, you on the island? No, oh, I'm on the island.
Word.
All right, yo. 1, 2, 3. Blackshun!
Let's get it.
Yo, we on? Yo, what's good, everybody? Yo, welcome to the Keep It A Buck podcast. Hold on, let me hit the air horn, yo. Hold on, man. That's weak. Hold on, 97 deserves more. Too much. How about this? That's good.
Yeah, that sounds right to the eardrum.
Word. That's like Goldilocks. You know, that was too much. That was too little. But that was just right. Oh, man. How's everybody doing? It's, what is it? It's been a long 3 days since y'all heard from us or whatever.
Very long 72 hours.
Word. A lot happens in 72 hours, yo. But before we get into, you know, the weekly fuck shit and address this comedy skit we call life, what's good with y'all lives?
Oh, my lives are feeling real good lately, you know. I got free time. My kids are going to school full time, you know, a little bit.
Hey! Yes, one, two, three. Fuck them kids.
Yes,
one, two, three.
Fuck them kids.
Fuck them kids. You know what I'm saying?
Teach them like I wasn't doing good. I thought I was.
Oh, damn. Yo, yeah, you got to teach her. You got to do the schooling, right? Damn,
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, my 12-year-old is smarter than me, so I didn't like that.
You became the student, too?
Yeah, I was not. Yeah. I didn't even know she was teaching me right, and I couldn't correct her. You got to go.
I'm fucking done. shit, you over there disrupting the teacher and shit.
Yeah, you got to go.
That's funny, yo.
But how y'all been?
Sure, everything's love on this side. I had an interesting call from my dad. Like, big Colin, you know what I'm saying? Called me, and the usual topic, our favorite topic is hip-hop.
Mm-hmm.
So we had a cool discussion about the good old days of, he used to drive this thing in New York City called the Mr. Softy truck, the ice cream truck. And
he sold weed on the side too?
Yeah, that too. But you know, we wind up going to Hollis Park where? And Steve Run DMC in the park, and we just was going back and forth about that.
Oh shit, okay, that's dope.
Okay,
that's
okay.
Dope. That's dope. That's dope. You got to see them, like literally see them.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And this is before they had like the Adidas.
Oh,
so this is, like,
snap.
They had
like,
the leather though, right?
Nah, not even that. They was dressed like they was about to go in the disco and shit.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, okay.
Yep, because then they switched it up. Mm-hmm. I forgot who told him, who gave him a game.
Jam Master J, rest in peace.
Yes,
rest in peace. Thank God they finally found his killer. Hip hop finally, like, you know.
What was for real?
Something. Like, oh my goodness. How long did it take?
20 years they found, like, in the. It's 20 years, right? It took 20 years to find out it was the motherfucker sleeping on his couch.
Word. He been 20 years just skating free.
Yeah, living
on
the day. You know what I'm saying? And like, and it was the dude sleeping on his fucking couch.
We
man.
Probably walked by this motherfucker in Queens.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You know,
like,
they go to the Coliseum or something. You
word.
Know what I'm
That's what I'm saying, man. You never fucking know.
Mm-hmm.
That's crazy, nigga. Like, that case took as long. Like, I got fucking cousins around that same age as like that case.
Yeah.
That's sad.
And that's a prime example of being mindful of your surroundings and people that you let in your circle.
That is true.
Yeah, that's facts.
Cause I remember a smart man told me, if you have 9 broke friends, you bound to be the 10th one.
Oh, that's a fact.
That's an ultra
so
fact.
So you better pretend, you better fake it.
For real.
Nah. Fake it till you make it, baby.
That's a fact. You never want to be the smartest man in the room, and you don't want to be the richest man in the room either.
No, you asking for it, you know, you asking for it. But, you know, after getting all the facts, I don't want to get too deep into it because it's really none of my motherfucking business.
Yeah, spitting on the internet.
But I got to say, in that game, that shit's treacherous.
That's,
you know,
a
what I'm saying?
Fact.
You got to be ready for the good, the bad,
and the
ugly.
Ugh.
That's a fact. That keep it a bug lessons right there. Take that as a note. Message. Take that as a note. Mental note. Any of y'all niggas trying to get into, like, you know, street shit or whatever, not set it on this album, man. Take it from a street dude. You don't need to be the street dude.
Nah, it's because sometimes, like, some people, it'd be like a pair of sneakers. Like, it fit all right, but it just don't fit just right.
Yeah, it's not a perfect fit.
And when it's like that, it ain't for you. If you 30 and you ain't pushing 1,000 grand, you know what I'm saying, retire.
Word. It ain't for you. Yo, there was a nigga down the street. From my crib, man. He's a legend, bro. He's only sold dimes and nicks.
Yes.
For like 20, 30 years. Like, anybody listening, like, if you were like 15, 20 years old or whatever, like, he might have served like your brother, your daddy.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Your auntie. Like, he,
I got one of those in my hood. Trap.
Yeah, but like, this nigga made a living. I didn't know what else this motherfucker did.
Word, that's a slow trap, though. Low trap, no. Police.
No, no, and then that's the one that they actually got. They'll take holidays off. Like, nope, don't come to my house on a holiday.
No.
Don't come to my house after a certain time.
Except with him, it was like he did have the certain time, but you can go like any day.
Oh, see, mine was no holidays. It was a certain time and no Sundays.
Oh shit, it was like a business.
Oh, that's how paid he was. He had rules.
Yeah, yeah, for you know the thirsty you know, niggas exactly. All day, 24/7.
No, you can only give me your money during these hours. That's it. That's how much money. Yeah.
Y'all, I
gotta
remember.
Get on that level.
I remember. What is it? I'm gonna say this, and then we're gonna get into a topic. But this shit was just mad funny though. I remember this was a couple years ago. I went over there to go get a dime and shit. Some fat ugly chick was in front of me and shit. And she really had the audacity to be like, yo, can I get a dime for Nick Price?
What the blood clot?
But wait, there's more. Can I get it for $2?
Get the hell on with your shit.
Bitch, you want a dime for a Nick and you don't even got the Nick Price?
Nope.
And you ugly on top of that?
Get on with yourself.
I was like, yo, she trying to do diva shit. I was like, who lied to her?
Yes. And I want to let you know this, too. Who lied to you? Because even the cute girls ain't even getting free weed nowadays. Y'all love some tight up. I was like, what happened in my generation? Y'all was just giving.
Nah.
This new one, you can't just sit there and just smile. They be like, no, this is loud. This is that cake song. This is that. What is that? Cream cheese or
that
the
cream cheese?
No, I'm fucking. I was like, oh my goodness, like, oh.
I remember the first time someone said, I got that gas, and it was really that real gas.
Yeah.
I was stupid high. Like,
facts. Facts. Hey, there's a new fucking name for weed every week.
Oh, yeah.
There's a new strand being made. Even the second, there's a new strand being made right now with a crazy ass name, nigga.
I don't know, man. Where I'm from, down in Tampa, man, just the regular project weed to get you stupid.
No, I'm a mom.
Yeah, had no name.
Give me the meds.
That's right.
I'll take some seeds in it.
Meds?
Yeah, I'm a med girl.
Oh, fuck that, man. That should give me a headache,
like,
man.
If I can't find it as of now since it's 2020, but yeah. I'm a meds girl.
That's a good thing.
Yeah, I know. My pockets
are
fat.
Trying to see them shits?
That's what I'm saying.
My pockets are fat. I buy a whole ounce.
Let me hook you up with a dude, because I be getting, like, some real good shit for quality price.
Yeah.
I get quantity and quality. That's what I look for. QQ, the double Qs.
Exactly.
You gotta look for that.
Exactly.
Stay on your P's and Q's.
For real.
100%. Shit, man. But, let's get into it, man. All right, let's get into it. What is it? Did y'all check up on the vice presidential debate last night?
You mean the fly trap?
The fly's the MVP. He's the MVP of the debate show, 100%.
Yeah.
Most definitely.
He smelled some bullshit, and he landed right on it.
I was just really laughing at Carmella's face whenever she detected some bullshit off of Mike Pence.
Yeah, it reminded me of like an ex-girlfriend or my mom.
Yeah,
she gave an auntie look like,
Yeah, right, nigga. Yeah, you know you're lying, right? Mm-hmm.
I'm talking. Remember that? Y'all see that shit? I was like,
And she said it so softly, too.
No, but that's the scary shit.
Exactly. That's what I love.
I went ahead. Mike Pence, nigga, you about to learn every lesson a black man learned. You can't argue with a black woman and win.
She was about to catch him.
What happened, though? moderator.
No. The moderators have been trash during the debate. Like,
they should have Andy Cohen.
They should have Duchess.
Yes. Who will be a great
if
moderator?
If you can keep the kids in line,
I can keep kids in line, but I will pick one line and don't stick to the other. You talk.
That's it.
That's what we need.
You say something, punch you right in your shit.
I'll be one-sided like
I'll
a mug.
Mother. Shit, man.
Yes.
But I feel like, you know what, a little bit, I felt like, you know, Kamala Harris was kind of like suppressing.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Her
most
blackness.
Definitely. But did you
bit?
See how she got off
she
that jet?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she came out with super
with
swaggy.
Sweat. I said, look at Obama Trump too.
Yes. They had dirt
they
on my shoulder blade.
Yes. They know how to serve us that wall.
You know what? I got to explain to our fans. What they witnessed, that was her melanin kicking in full blast.
Full blown. I said, go ahead with the Timbs and all.
When
pump
you
it.
See someone of color word. That just walked that walk and got that certain swag about that motherfucker. That comes from the sun 93 million miles away. Right up on our skin, and that gives us our energy, our special power.
Yeah, we like Superman
for real
and shit.
That was swagalicious right there.
Oh,
I can
hell
give you
yeah.
that one, Mama.
They had
you
dirt
you gave me confidence. I said, oh, we ain't gonna need to have her back on this. She got her own. She walked in there like, I got my own back.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. She defended, Joe Biden throughout the whole thing. I felt like she didn't really get to her points like that, but
exactly.
She had the back
nigga, the
white man up.
My nigga. Oh.
It's not just my microphones now.
Hold on. Hey, yo, did y'all see Jim Carrey as Joe Biden?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we're going to get into the SNL because I got a hot take.
Okay.
I got a deaf hot take for that. But do you think, was anything accomplished?
No.
At all. Nothing got done. It seemed like they was in a pissing match.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And nothing got, it was like a one of them, what do you call it, an old Mexican standoff.
Well, mm-hmm. They was pretty much, what I saw was defending their president.
Right. And it was more productive than a presidential debate.
Yeah, but the bar was set so low, my nigga.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
exactly.
Anything.
And
that.
That's bad
the
that
SNL
we tuned
no.
in what to see saying? The ratchetness. That's what the viewers were, because we've seen the president's acting ratchet, so we're like, oh, what are the vice presidents going to do?
Yeah,
like,
right.
Let's see.
He's like,
yo,
let's go.
But this is part two.
And she's black. Let's get it.
Exactly.
We
really
tuned
in for the ratchetness, and thank goodness they didn't serve us the ratchetness as much. But 2020, it's just like.
You don't feel like, I felt like I wanted Kamala Harris to go at Pence the way she went at Joe Biden.
Oh that's
like,
what
like, had that
but
motherfucker trembling.
Little,
nigga, like.
Joe put fire underneath her. You got to understand once you got something like, oh, I'm about to burn you. Oh, he pissed her off a couple of times.
Yeah.
He pissed her off a couple of times. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, once you feel like she's no bully. She's mm-hmm. like, I'm going to just.
She reminds me of a fucking principal.
Yeah,
like
exactly.
Principal.
She's like, all right, you
like
know where you're wrong. I'm
going
to point you where you're wrong and how you can correct yourself.
Exactly.
That was kind of boring a little bit, but you know.
No. See, like I feel you. Like, you know, last week they kind of, you know, it was different.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but I will say that shit was well better. You know, it was more mature. Even though
last week,
yeah,
100%.
Even though like Trump was acting more of a nigga than you know.
Oh, he came out swinging.
Like he was a nigga.
He said, "Now you ain't gonna forget about me this week."
Oh,
exactly.
He came out swinging, giving thumbs up and orange.
Now that's a fact.
Yeah.
Yo, the orange god is rose again.
Mm-hmm.
Shit, man.
I said, ooh, look at that spray. Oh no.
Yo, he stays firm to that. I think it's just his face that sprayed.
Yeah,
orange.
I think
everything
so.
Else is just pasty.
I think so. My kneecaps is probably just like.
I tell you, the POTUS took his Clorox tabs and his Lysol shot and got his ass right the fuck about the hospital.
Yeah.
He said, fuck you, driver. I don't care about your fucking family.
Yo.
He said, I don't give a shit. I'm taking my mask off.
Yo.
Fuck y'all, I'm gangster.
Yo,
and then, but
yo,
did you
facts,
see how he came back
facts.
Out, though?
Like he's Lord Sidious or
he
somebody.
Was like, turn the fans off.
You
turn.
Got the number?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, let's put the. Yeah. If anybody want to call in and give out their point of view or how they feel about how the debate went, call in. 479, what was it, 401?
No, it's 479. Hold on.
I was about to say, don't tell me you know the number better than me.
Nah, I had posted it up
I'm
on the
really
lobby,
that high.
But, you know, it's a new number. Be patient.
Oh, no. 479-407-1341. Hit that up. Keep it a buck hotline, yo. Keep it a buck with us. Give out your 2 cents.
Yeah.
I'd like to hear that shit. But back to that debate, though. I feel like not even the debate, though. I want to get to Joe Biden now. I feel like he should really be revving up these ads that say fuck Donald Trump, because Donald Trump would do the same thing if Biden was like had COVID.
Yes.
Right,
oh my
and
goodness.
He would mock that mask shit even more. It's like, look, he was wearing the mask all the time and he still caught it.
Let me tell you something. If shoe was on the other foot, Donald Trump be like Cobra Commander. Attack!
Exactly. He's down. Get him.
Attack! Exactly. Get him! For
and
real.
Sick him.
Yep, and every swinging dick would be out. All them white supremacist group, going to the store with getting tiki torches. Giving a paying homage and shit.
That's crazy that tiki torches is part of like the racist starter kit.
Listen now, like, I work at a certain store. I'm not gonna say which one, but I make sure them tiki torches are hard to find.
I'm done. You be on patrol. Patrol.
Word is born. I make sure them motherfuckers is hard to find. Goddamn.
Nigga be giving them the evil eye and shit, nigga. It's like, what
you
doing
you
with that tiki torch?
Who buying these goddamn things?
Yeah.
I'm following you.
Hey, Colin.
Excuse me.
Where you going with that?
Excuse me, sir. Do you know where the tiki torches is? Nah, we ain't got no more, motherfucker. We ain't got no more.
No. This is the fuck you want a tiki torch anyway, nigga? What the fuck? Stupid asses. That's fucking crazy, man.
That is the new normal.
Yo, for real.
I'm scared, man. Like that's fucked up, man. You gotta be scared. Oh yeah, you gotta be scared.
Yo, so y'all agree with me? Joe Biden should be going harder, like doubling down, especially
the question.
You know, especially like, you know, he was really going really out of his way flirting with COVID for months.
Right.
Not doing thousands of rallies with mask.
Yeah.
Can he go any harder? You look like you blow a strong wind or blow him the fuck over.
Who?
Biden.
Could he go any harder?
You know he's in the lead right
if
now.
He does, he look like he'll have a goddamn fall out.
For real.
He
looked like he was about to have an aneurysm when he told him to shut up.
For real.
Oh, yeah.
I was just like, God damn. Hey, both of these presidents might not live, you know, the next term. So we don't know.
That was another perspective about this last debate. These two people, we had to pay attention to their politics too and their ways of action, because they may quite just be the next president, whether we like it or not.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
That's what's terrifying.
Yeah, literally. Mike Pence tomorrow can be the president if Trump fucking falls the fuck out. That damn experimental medicine makes his insides melt.
Experimental medicine.
Oh,
yo.
My goodness. He said everybody should have a
And he gambled his life. And that's the crazy shit about him. He gambled his life.
Yeah.
On the election. He said, in his mind, give me the shot, doc. If this works, I'm going to go out there. I'm going to give it to you free.
Yes.
You know, this shit is amazing. Thank to all the people.
It even tastes good.
Yeah. It tastes like Flintstone vitamins. You'll live.
Yeah.
Don't be afraid. You might just die tomorrow, but you might not. I don't know.
Look at me.
Imagine you just collapsed.
This is our leadership, man. This is even more of a reason Biden should really be revving that shit up to go at him.
Mm.
Trump supporters are more...
Biden's acting like he's the one that has COVID.
I know. You don't see him out nowhere. I mean,
he
was down in Miami.
Right there, that Trump just said it just to get ahead of him, and that was, you know.
Yeah, well, I think he's
acting like he's the one that got it. He's not trying to do much.
Well, he's just being smart.
Right now, he could just coast. I hope he doesn't have that mentality. You ever see,
he might put his foot in his mouth.
Ooh. Yeah, like, I hope he doesn't coast. Like, you ever see like a
which white man you talking about?
Biden. Okay. You know, like you ever see like one of them sprinters?
Mm-hmm.
They might think they're gonna win.
Oh yeah.
And then it'll be the guy still grinding and whiz right by them.
Yeah.
At the last second.
You know what Trump's gonna do? He's gonna hold them stimulus checks all the way to the end.
Yeah, you want this shit?
Yo,
Biden
you know
would
what?
Never do this. He would never
yeah.
give you stimulus.
October 29th is never gonna hit our account.
I guarantee
that's
you.
What he said,
just,
though.
Yeah.
That's what he said.
That'd
so
be
like,
enough to swing a vote.
Yo,
because it's gonna be still fresh in our minds that ooh, Trump just gave us money.
Look what I did for you niggas. I gave you all $1,200. Go vote.
Don't be some ungrateful niggas.
Oops, my bad. Edit that. Pence. It's the COVID
done.
Talking. It's a symptom.
No, but the thing is, I don't think this much, like, I really am on the fence if he has this. Because remember what I said, I think, Sunday? That this is just a whole ploy.
Yeah.
For this nigga just, you know, to get sympathy. He takes this fake serum
yeah.
or whatever it is that he got from his pharmaceutical friends who are also his golf buddies.
Mm-hmm. It's no different than, I agree with you, it's no different than, like, say, the Patriots. Cam Newton goes down, they get their ass handed to them.
Yeah.
Then now you hear, oh, he might be available for next week.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's crazy business.
That's crazy.
That's
why they investigating them? You think it's...
I think that's crazy business,
man.
I'm saying, man, don't do that. You're putting people at risk.
Was it Charles Barkley? Not Charles Barkley, the other one.
Shaquille O'Neal?
No, but AIDS.
Magic Johnson. Magic Johnson.
Magic Johnson.
Mm-hmm.
It could have been just like him. They had the cure for that, and he got
Magic had
quiet
that.
On the low, and they still let people
but he got money.
Yeah.
He got
exactly.
Money.
Trump got money.
Yeah, he had money for that. Magic had that money for the experimental shit back then that's
mm-hmm.
available every day now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That kept him... One thing I can say about that AIDS medicine that's different from COVID, it's about being disciplined with the medicine.
Yeah.
If you discipline with the medicine, you'll live. I know someone, like, take my uncle, 30 years I've known him with that shit, and he's still wilding. You know what
mm-hmm.
I'm saying? Like nothing wrong. So
mm-hmm.
take the medicine, you'll be all right. But COVID is tagged, you were it, you're fucked, and that's crazy.
Yeah.
And for them to...
But they might already have the cure. That's the messed up part.
Oh, no, see.
Because all these celebrities that mm-hmm. got it, they ain't, you know, always, you know.
Now, but the thing is, like, you can, like, it can leave your body.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It just depends on, like, you know, what type of conditions you have or what
it
type of health you have.
It might just be vitamin C.
Yeah, you never know. Some people, you know, like, Trump is really the prime target. He's old, he's fat. You know what I'm saying? Like, it kills these type of people. It does. He's morbid obese.
He look, he
and he's old, nigga. He's 70 something. He's fucking the early bird special age.
Yeah.
Like,
why they gotta be so old?
Yeah.
It's not like they come with knowledge now.
Yeah,
no, usually when we wanted somebody older because they came with knowledge, they came with wisdom.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
These mother hubbards are coming up with nothing. They are looking to their side people so strong.
Yeah, you're right about that. Like the young presidents always seem to do good.
Yes,
can
Kennedy,
they run a mile with
Clinton,
us? Like
Bush got voted in twice. You know what I'm saying?
Well,
like
you know why I like Clinton, man. You know I like Clinton. You know?
Clinton was a puppet.
Yeah. Hey, fuck it, man. He did my dream. He got hit in the White House.
Yes,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's my dream, you know.
You know where he fucked up at?
What?
Yeah.
Enough said.
You know what I'm saying? This is something between me and my wife.
Yeah.
And, you know, this ain't got nothing to do with my job.
Yeah.
Exactly. I was like, I'm a president. I'm
yeah.
not a priest.
They put it
yeah.
in his head
like,
that if you can't control your husband or your wife, you know, you can't control the world. Nobody
True.
Is like that.
True.
Hold
like,
on.
Yeah, but
that, and she does have thing. A point. If he shows the world he lacks the discipline to follow his vows, who's to say he's gonna have the same discipline not to hit the button
yeah.
when it's time?
Nah, but nigga, pussy and the button is two different things.
Wow, is it?
I've never been in front of the button, so I don't know.
Listen, if you're a married man,
I've been in front of the other thing.
If you're a married man, pussy will be the button. The deck.
Yeah.
will blow all your shit
up.
Press the button.
Finish him. For real. Ask Dr. Dre.
Mm. press the button.
Yo, no, the judge pressed the button. Like, well, fuck that shit.
Juanita Jordan, man. They gonna wipe it down.
Shit, man. But, yeah, no, nah, I feel you guys, though. You know, the presidential race should be younger, browner. You know what I'm saying? Like, it shouldn't be getting older and whiter.
Especially if, you know, if anybody can do it, like, qualify for the job.
Now that it's been proven.
Yeah, then.
No, that's a fact.
I agree that we needed a businessman the way the economy was after Obama, right? And I, you know, for not that guy.
Never mind.
You know what I'm saying? Like I was down with, you know, someone not a crooked traditional politician, someone that was a businessman. You know what I'm saying? But I thought it would be cool, but not that guy. The wrong guy, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm sure like there's other philanthropists. How you say that name?
Philanthropists
out there that are worthy of the job. Got that good, see?
It's the glasses. It's the glasses now. Nah. But damn. Oh, Obama's last 3 years though, he put in a lot of work, and Trump was reaping the benefits of what he placed. Mm-hmm. So that's why he be saying my economy. Mm-hmm. The economy. It's like you know, the white man always taking credit over what the black guy did. Yeah. You know?
As the jazz artist.
Yeah, you know, yeah, exactly. As jazz, Louis. As rock and roll.
Louis.
Now it's hip hop.
For real.
You know what I'm saying?
Hip hop is like, what is whitewashed?
You know what I'm saying, man? It's just crazy. But, yeah, man, this is, it's crazy. If I'm Joe Biden, man, I'm doubling down on fuck Trump ads. 100%, and I would definitely maximize on him being careless with being having the coronavirus and being contagious, deadly contagious, and going around doing photo ops.
Photo ops.
It's crazy.
He told them turn the fan off. I'm going back out so he can salute longer.
Yeah, he was all like, "I was trying to show the Americans that I'm not scared." It was just like, "Nigga, what are you doing?" He said, "Every leader."
Why did you take your mask off and go back in there and endanger other people?
I know that's how you got it the first time.
He has a security plate that has to be in the same car with him.
Yeah,
and he's telling them to take extra laps. No, you are in danger.
I wouldn't have said
COVID.
No.
You no.
That, when I seen him go for the joyride when he was in the hospital, in my mind I said, "Damn." The staff. What about
yes,
the family?
You
damn. What about the driver? Damn. How you circulating the
that
air
wife
inside
is
the
so
Suburban.
Mad right now.
If one of them got a black
driver's wife.
Yes.
Oh.
He's like, nigga, you better not
she
come home too, nigga.
In that day. She called in. What am I watching on
right,
TV?
Right. You know what I'm saying? Like,
is that you driving?
It was so much. and then when I seen that he was going back, like, he got on the helicopter, went back to the White House. In my mind, I'm going, damn. The staff, the butlers, the waiters,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying. All them brothers and sisters that secretly make that place work,
they
are in danger. I wouldn't want to go to work, man.
Yeah, nigga,
literally,
I'll
be paranoid of that
out.
Shit.
I'm
and
out.
In his inner circle, 19 of them niggas got that shit
quickly.
Yeah,
that's a fact.
Just
bing,
like
bing,
that.
Bing, 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 bing. I was
Yeah, nah, that's a fact. They ran through the whole White House. This is crazy. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I'm still kind of, you know, 50-50 if he got it or not. You know what I'm saying? Like, I got to see this motherfucker, like, really, like.
You never know what's real with him.
On
his
the
pictures
bed,
are not
like,
even real.
On a respirator. Yeah. I need
like,
to see
he
that.
He had a magic marker, was it? When he was acting like he was doing his work or something like that? It wasn't. I forgot what type of pen it was. It wasn't, an ink pen?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was smoking mirror. He got more smoking mirrors than David Copperfield.
Yeah, no, that's a fact. But
he's doing it so much. It's like, are you trying to let us know that this is all bull stuff? Like, was this your goal?
That's why The Fly was there.
This movie,
that's
and then
work
they're
gonna
sit there and say that it was edited. I guarantee you.
The movie
for
this,
for real, fake news.
Yeah.
The movie that they're gonna put out for this presidency is gonna be fire.
Oh.
You know how like they had W that. They're going to have this one for sure.
Watch
this is going to be fire.
The Comey Rule.
Okay.
Watch that shit. It was on Showtime.
Okay.
It's about how, what is it? the FBI was doing an investigation on Trump, mm-hmm. and he fired the, what is his name, James Comey.
Yeah, the FBI director.
Yeah, mm-hmm. exactly.
Oh, so he
it's
got
already
close.
Written. Like, if they already got a TV series in process, like, of what happened the last 4 years, you know it's already in production.
And this was
this
just the beginning.
Years.
This was just 2016, 17.
Yeah.
Like, he fired that nigga the first year because he felt like he couldn't trust him. He was pretty much just saying, like, I need you to just fuck all the rules and just do what I tell you to do.
I'm sorry, sir.
Yeah, I need you to investigate. Voila, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, and then he had this dude, Michael Cohen, cover everything up.
Yeah, exactly. It's crazy. They showed all that shit. You got to watch it. You got to watch that.
Yeah.
Go check that shit out, people. Definitely.
It sounds like it's fire.
Nah, it was fire. The production, it's two episodes only.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a mini series.
Right.
And it's about an hour, both episodes. It's really good. Go check that shit out. It's on Showtime. Go say if you can't afford Showtime, Fire Stick that shit.
Stick it.
Word.
Stick it.
Word. I know you niggas got Wi-Fi. Know that.
Exactly.
That's a fact. Shit, niggas be on fucking Instagram all fucking day and shit.
I know that's right. Hotspot something.
Facts.
I be forgetting to turn my Wi-Fi on. You know that, guys? Just using all the phone data.
I'm fucking done.
I be doing that too sometimes.
What is it? SNL, man. Let's talk about SNL.
That was fucking fire. Jim Carrey came out with the aviator jaunts. He went,
That shit was good. That shit was good. What is it? Chris Rock hosted my favorite comedian, Chris Rock, hosted the SNL. What was it? Saturday. I got to watch it yesterday. I was blunted. I saw all the skits. That shit was funny.
Yes.
Monologue was... Of course, Chris is A1, man. What was that about the name change? That skit was fucking hilarious,
yeah.
Bro. That shit was hilarious.
It has edge. It had edge.
That's what it was missing.
Yeah.
That's what SNL has been fucking missing.
Like, I'm gonna quote Brother Mooney. Everybody loves pancakes, fluff.
Yeah.
But
no edge.
No edge, man. Gotta have the edge, man.
Yeah, man. It's just like that shit was all the skits, man. The ghost from the future shit was funny. Like, all that shit was good, man. I was just like, yo, this is the only time SNL's really good is when they got like a great comedian who's able to fucking write his own sketches and do the monologue and shit.
Anytime you see Rock, Murphy,
yeah,
Morgan, you know what I'm saying? What's that sister name, man? Dang. Leslie O'Neill, mm-hmm. She's stupid.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Shout out to them, though. No, for real. What is that? I got a hot take, though.
Mm-hmm.
I got a hot take.
Mm-hmm.
I think that episode, Chris Rock's reunion, was better than Eddie Murphy's reunion.
Oh, yeah.
Word is born, and you know how I feel.
I thought I was gonna get static. I thought I was gonna get static.
It seems like they switched roles.
Hold up.
Because remember how Chris Rock was more whitewashed in the beginning? They switched roles. Now it's you know Eddie. You know.
Eddie, like his problem.
But what was the late 90s? Chris was his, fire.
Yeah, his thing like Eddie didn't bring nothing new. He came with Gumby.
Yeah.
2020 don't know Gumby.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
No,
he came
they
with,
didn't cherish that.
He should have did like Lizzo at the Laker game.
Yeah, no. Sit
your ass down. What you
Lizzo,
doing?
Yeah.
Lizzo and Eddie Professor, the clumps.
That shit would have been funny.
Yeah. But it would, yeah, because like you said, they were missing edge.
Mm-hmm.
And
no edge.
They took it to the edge.
I saw.
And speaking of taking it to the edge, we definitely got to shout out our girl Meg Thee Stallion for her first live performance since her getting, you know, that injury. Because she killed it. And she was representing us for
another
black
one.
Females. But Breonna Taylor, you know.
Damn, son. Where'd you find this?
I thought that her performance was right on time.
Yes, it was.
It was political.
Mm-hmm.
It was black. And I felt that shit to my core, man. Yes. I felt that shit.
What was it?
Huh?
What was it again?
It was political.
No. Say black.
It was a black.
It's a black.
That's with a Q in it.
Yeah. Yeah. For real.
Now, if you from down south, that's black.
Shots fired.
My
black.
Bad.
Did you just say black? No, black.
Black.
We black. That shit was dope.
Yeah.
That shit was dope. I thought
she's getting good reviews on it. So.
Yeah. How can you hate though? You can't hate on black women now.
Oh yes, they can. That bitch is wearing high heels. She wasn't shot. Like, cause that was a lot in the comments.
She
so
had to
was,
been. There had to been some pain. Like. Some
things got kicked right off so fast. I know that's right. Because even if you didn't get shot, them things are getting kicked right off.
I was about to say that.
I'd have been out there with a cool ass wheelchair.
Mm-hmm. I would have rolled up there like an
For real. And then they play the music and just come up like, bounce.
Exactly.
But damn, yo, she was looking good.
Shout out.
She was looking good. Shout the chocolate out. Was looking good. nigga was trying to dip in the chocolate. A little stir.
A little
peanut
stallion.
Butter in the chocolate.
Hey,
you know? Stallion. Shit. She was looking good, though. 100%. Doing the thing. Yo, she's bodying this whole fucking,
the rap game right now.
Like, I haven't seen somebody body getting shot since 50 Cent.
What?
Like,
No, 50
shit.
Was like, no, he did it.
Yeah.
He did it. They did it. At least it took her a little bit of time to say something, you know. But, yeah, she did body it.
But
that's nothing that we should be promoting. We do not need to be bodying nothing like that.
No. But you know, you did. So we got to comment on it. You know, we got to applaud it, yo. For real.
Girls like thinking that. It's cool.
Shout out to Black Girl Man.
No, you ain't. If he shoot me, I don't care. I'm coming back at him. No, wait a minute. No.
That you shot. Like, what the fuck?
I don't care.
Is this a game?
Wait a minute.
It's like, oh, shit, I got 75%.
Do you know that it was just fragments that hit her? That wasn't a real bullet, right?
It don't matter.
Like, Boo-Boo, you're not sure that you're going to catch the same thing that she caught.
Have you been shot before? Like,
thank
the fuck?
You pop that girl in the damn hand, she probably say, ow.
Exactly, yo. What'd you guys say, man? What'd you guys say?
No, I
was that
bad.
Some more of the red button?
I felt so bad for her, man. Like, you know what I'm saying with her foot? Because I know how it is. I pull it in your foot.
She was doing better than me. All of us.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to let you know that right now. She was
bodying that
shit.
I would have been still milking on the Today Show.
I'm so proud of her. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm elaborate. Okay, so this is why I'm feeling Meg Thee Stallion in her performance. And how I understand how it feels to be shot in the foot. All right, so y'all, everybody know, I wasn't always a comic. I used to sell rocks. Okay, so I just got this new gun.
There goes our sponsors.
I'm sorry.
Bam, bam, bam.
Edit button.
I'm not proud of this shit.
Definitely send me this shit so I can edit it.
I'm not proud of the shit. I'm just.
She learned.
I'm just giving an example of why you should not participate in the shit. So, boom. All right, so I bought this new gun, right? And I didn't test it out and shit. So I bought the gun. I went to go get my work, and I went to this spot on Knight and Carpenter. Never forget it. Right, not too far from here, right? So
yeah.
I'm rocking that night.
Yeah,
it's like New Year's Eve. Yo, it's crowded like a dick, and in my mind, it's too many people in here.
Yeah,
put your shit on off safety. All right, so.
You didn't shoot yourself in the foot.
Listen, the door went like this. I said, yo, wait a minute. What the fuck? I get up and I just had this fucking this new bubble goose leather shit on. I was fresh. You hear me, y'all? I was fresh.
Yeah.
I put my hand on the gun and stood up. And before I could whip it out my pocket, bam! Shot through my goose. There was goose feathers everywhere.
Oh, shit.
My fucking foot, I fucking hit the floor. Splat! Yo, on my mama. You don't really notice how fucking much it hurt until you smell the flesh.
Yeah.
And then I Right? These niggas fucking dragged me outside down the staircase, right? I'm fucking bleeding. They run in my pockets. They took my rocks, my money, all that shit. I'm like, what the fuck, right? I'm trying to fight, and the next thing I know, I see, bah, bah, bah. And the lady that I was renting her house, I was selling my rocks at, Miss Captain, love her to this day. Leave him alone. And her daughter came. She took my gun. She took my gun, and I had the little bit of rocks I had in cash. I said, here. Yeah. And she said, you all going to leave him alone. So waited for the ambulance. They took like an hour and a half. I'm sitting there bleeding like a stuck hog, right? In my mind, I'm going to die, right? That's what happens when you shot. In your mind, you're going to die. All right.
Yeah.
All right. So the ambulance come. They get me. They driving slower than the motherfucker. In my mind, I'm going to die.
They
all right. So,
in this area.
So they say, okay, Mr. Felder, I'm going to stick this in your foot. If you hear boom, 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 you're going to keep your foot. But if you don't hear shit, we got to cut your shit. So in my mind, I'm going, damn, I'm done for.
They better hear this shit.
And so before he stuck his foot on the pin in my foot, I look at him. I said, damn. How I'm going to get any pussy with no foot?
No, so, my goodness.
Nah,
he went from, I'm going to die to, wait
nigga,
a minute, no nah, puss.
Nigga, nah, you can
I can't
pussy,
stand
nigga.
Men.
Yo, I know mad niggas in wheelchairs
yo,
getting pussy, nigga.
Then I went, why you niggas driving so fucking slow, man? Hurry the fuck up.
Captain Dan was getting pussy.
For real. Hey, I cooked a kente just a pussy, nigga.
So,
you see?
Listen, he pulled my shoe off. I see blood spurt. I black out, and I wake up to my mom and stepfather. And my stepfather had a .44 Magnum, like Dirty Harry, and he cocked it back. Clap.
Oh, shit.
Young man, defend yourself, Mr. Lee, rest in peace, and put it behind my pillow. And then, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It went from there. But
even
yeah.
though you shot yourself, yeah. defend yourself from yourself. No, you should have told them what happened. Get it away from me.
I'm a danger to myself.
Oh, my God, man.
Yo, nah, he wouldn't snitch on himself.
Nah.
He's a real nigga. He's a real nigga.
Yo,
I know that's
bad.
Right. Keep the code.
For real. Yo, Lord, nigga, you Meg and Tory, nigga.
Yeah, that shit was wild.
This nigga's Meg and Tory at the same time.
Exactly.
That's crazy,
yo,
bro.
From then on, like when I buy, like if I ever bought like a toy, I went to the papa, you know.
Yeah.
And test it and shit. Or now the gun range, because, you know, I'm legal.
Yeah, no. I feel you. I feel you on that. I feel you. That's a funny story, nigga.
Yes.
That's Collins Corner right there.
Don't sell rocks is the damn message.
That's the message.
Yeah, don't sell no rocks.
Don't sell rocks and don't smoke rocks.
Exactly.
That's the good, the bad. Yeah, that's the
facts.
You can make $1 million. Some bullshit could happen just like that.
Yeah, anything could happen. Mm-hmm. Anything, man.
Damn, that was all beat like a motherfucker. I'm sorry, y'all.
No, but it had to do with, like, tied in, you know, getting shot. You got shot, she got shot, you know, said, you know, you're a victim to yourself. But, you know, yo, that shit's fucking crazy. Yo, my boy's fucking wild. My boy's fucking wild, yo. Yo, that shit's funny. All right, so, you want to do a weird but true?
Oh, yeah, hold on.
Hey, Alex. Yo, can you turn that screen off? I was just trying to put that that graphic up, I guess. Technical difficulties. Yeah, I'm trying to put it live on the screen.
Yeah, so you got to email me so I can put it on the screen.
Oh, I thought you could just rip it from the flash drive.
Oh.
Yeah.
All right, I got a good one. You tell me when it's ready.
Yeah. That was what is it? I know this is your shit. So I was just like, yo, let's give Colin a segment real quick so he can get this shit off.
I found this on the web.
No, we was not talking to you, Google.
That's
another thing.
tripping like earlier, like with that shit. We gonna get into that.
Everything.
Word. Damn, yo. I'm gonna be fucking sick. I mean, yeah. I second guess everything, but.
Oh, yeah, that means shit.
That's just crazy.
After a while, you're just like, well, fuck it, come and get me then.
Well, you know what? While we waiting for that, yeah, you wanna get into the. Okay, hold on.
Okay, here we go. This is something that I call weird but true. Okay. A Bronx high school teacher was arrested for performing oral sex on one of her students back in 2016. Dori Myers, for her heinous crime, was sent to, she only got 10 years of probation for her heinous crime. Me, in my mind, I'm going, she shouldn't got no probation, no time at all for giving this young man unsurmountable self-confidence for the rest of his life. She just gave him incredible swag. Can't tell that young man shit. Let's see. Let's go back some more. Okay. A Detroit goon was arrested yesterday. Darren Wilson, evidently he robbed two men, one white and one black. So I guess during the middle of the robbery, he looked at the black man and said that he don't rob black people. So he let him go and he robbed the white guy. So the black guy ran and got the cops and they arrested Darren Wilson. So in the back of my mind, white people got Robin Hood, we just got Robin.
Robin in the hood.
Exactly.
That was a white dude?
Mm-hmm.
That figures. You didn't even have to play What's That Race.
Here's a good one. An 88-year-old man was arrested in Apollo Beach, Florida after setting his 45-year-old girlfriend on fire after she was complaining of erection problems. I guess, you know, after the investigators had asked Mrs. Smith, why did he commit this heinous crime? She quote unquote said that he didn't light her fire anymore. I guess evidently he did, god damn it. Hashtag lit her ass up, man. That's
fucked up. Yo, you really like when you researching this type of shit, man, you kind of really like understand that there's some wild motherfuckers in the world, man.
Yeah, man.
Like different breeds, man. Like different.
I think like the worst one I've ever heard was a Catholic priest. He was arrested for child porn. I guess he was a part of this gambling ring, and
nigga,
he lost a lot of money. He lost a lot of money of the church's
that's
money.
That's where the collection plate money going
to? He lost a lot
that's
of the church's
crazy.
Money, and he punished himself by collecting child porn.
He punished.
That was his punishment.
That was his punishment. That's what he told the cops.
Yeah,
that was his pleasure.
And the damn, like, I got to thinking that Catholicism isn't too bad. You know, you can be a total psychopath, sociopath, maniac, go to church, do some Hail Marys, All Fathers, and be washed.
For real.
Just like that, you're going to heaven, man. Shit. I'm Muslim. All the crooked shit I do.
No. But that's mad strict, though. It was like, nigga, I eat a rib, nigga, I'm off this shit.
Yeah.
I was like, nigga, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know how good bacon is?
No.
It's like, I eat a bacon, nigga, and I'm fucking disowned?
Yes.
That's
exactly.
Just crazy. You know, that's why mad niggas is fucking, you know, Christian and Catholic. It's like being
better
Trump.
Eating selection,
it's like,
you know?
No matter what the fuck I do, I can't get out of this shit. Mm. I can't get kicked out.
Okay.
You know?
Hell yeah, boy. One more. Did you know that you can get a degree in the art and science of growing and selling marijuana from Northern Michigan University?
What's the addy?
Exactly.
Yeah, what's the addy?
I guess because you know, because of the spike of medical marijuana and, you know, everybody's making money, that now that's a whole thing.
Yeah, it's like,
they're like, oh, our state can make some money. Like, we got a whole bunch of land.
In my mind, I'm going back to school to get my motherfucking GED, man. I'm going to Northern Michigan University, man. I got to come up, man. The struggle's real. It's never too late. I got to go get my shit, man.
Word, nigga.
Keep it a buck. We'll find you how much that is, okay?
No, we will. We will. Anybody who's listening, though, if you can find it before he does, send me that shit.
Exactly.
100%. For real. I need an in on that. It's crazy how they was really like locking motherfuckers up for this
exact thing.
And now they're profiting off it.
I remember getting,
because of lucrative business.
I remember getting my car towed for an ashtray full of roaches.
Oh yeah, that's still in North Carolina.
Yeah.
That still happens. You will know, they will lock you up, tow your car, everything for a roach.
And they'll smoke that shit right
now. Not even just an ashtray full, a roach.
Yeah.
That's fucking wild, nigga.
But they'll sell you all the game, tobacco.
Of course. They set that shit up.
Yeah.
For real.
They will set that shit up for you.
If you would think that they, you know, like, hey, oh, but they're using that for that. Like, they would just stop selling it since it's a no-smoke state.
Yeah, that's fucking crazy.
They set them up. They'll sit there at the corner stores and their little bodegas that everybody done planted down in North Carolina.
Yeah.
They do got bodegas there.
Nah. Spanish people, they know where the money's at. Nah, they do.
And
they do.
Knock them off. Oh, this one got a whole pack. Oh, this one got a whole pack.
Exactly. After you just bought it, too.
Knock them right off.
That's fucked up, man.
That's entrapment.
That's how they get niggas. And they give you the product, and then they fucking get you for the product.
Exactly.
That's crazy. That's fucking crazy, man. But all right, man. That was good and informative. Let you know that the world is more fucked up than it is. what do you got for conspiracies? Dutch's conspiracy.
All right. For this week, I do have a good one, and it is called the Mandela Effect.
Oh, yeah, yo. This shit fucked me up. This is the part, if you haven't been smoking during the podcast, smoke now. This shit fucked me up when we was like, you know, doing a pre-game before this. And so, it's about to fuck you up too, brother.
So this conspiracy was named after Nelson Mandela, because some people remember when Nelson Mandela passed away in jail. And then some people remember when, like, nope, he got out when he was president for a long time. And then that's when he passed away. So, but people are like, no, like, we seen this funeral on TV. We cried. No, he was dead. Like, like, so that's when this started to happen. So, example number one, Looney Tunes. Do you remember it being spelt like cartoons or like the tunes that we listen into our music, listen to?
Yeah, like a jammy jam.
Yeah, the tunes.
I remember it actually both ways. Yeah. I don't know if that's my memory or the weed kicking in, but
I can only
remember
the music.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Yep, well, they're trying to say that it was only T-U-N-S, and never the T-O-O-N-S.
Wow.
Huh.
Then that just fucked up my whole childhood.
No, I'm about to fuck up your childhood right now.
That was a lie.
So, everybody read the book, Curtis DeGeorge?
Oh, yeah, Deep Philosophy.
Yes. Everybody likes George.
Word.
All right, so did George have a tail or no?
I mean, he's a monkey, right?
Right? You would think.
An emasculated monkey without a tail.
And that's
don't remember him with a tail.
Well, he has no tail, but everybody remembers him swinging off the trees in episodes.
Word is born, right?
holy shit. Hold up.
For real.
You know, that's crazy because she told me this already, and it fucked me up the second time. More than the first time.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's the double meaning.
All right. So this one goes out to all the fellas.
Yeah.
Pokemon, the character Pikachu.
Oh, y'all remember Pokemon. Come on.
I'm the old nigga on the side. I don't know.
Did he have a black tip or no black tip?
I got a black tip.
On his tail.
Not you, nigga. Not nigga, man.
You hear me? On his tail. On his tail. Pokemon does have a tail.
Oh, my bad. My bad. Sorry. He's like, nah, I'm talking about my tail, nigga. Nah, I remember black tip.
All right. They're trying
pause
to say
now.
That
pause
he
now.
Never
I
did.
Saying, I gotta say pause now.
Yep. He never had a black tip on his tail. All right. And one more for the men, since y'all like to have y'all white tees. What was the logo of the Fruit of the Loom logo? Did it have a basket with the fruit or just fruit?
I thought it was just the fruit. The silhouette of the fruit.
And you?
Shit. See, I was never a Fruit Loops guy.
The t-shirt?
Yeah, Fruit of the Loom. Fruit of the Loom.
Oh,
the logo.
On the back.
Yep.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
All right. Yeah, it was F, like fruit. Like
yeah.
Fruit.
Yeah, but fruit. Did it have a basket or no basket?
No basket. It was fruit. It was just fruit.
Yeah, they was on their feet.
They was standing up.
There.
Yeah.
It was like four of them.
Remember the commercial?
Basket.
It had a basket? Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yo, you fucked me up.
My snackers.
Yo,
everybody loves the snack Cheez-Its, right?
Yeah, that's Cheez-Its. The best fatty.
Now,
food.
Was it Cheez-Its, cheese, or was it Cheez-It?
Nah, there was a Z.
It's Cheez-It, one word.
No, there was
but with a Z or without one?
That was a Z. It was a Z.
Yeah.
That's my shit. That's
they're trying Z. To say it never was one.
Wow. Wow. I thought it was spelled how it sounds.
Yo, yeah. That's fucking crazy.
Okay, so this goes for all the old heads and their old cartoons. All
right, man, this is for you, man.
Flintstones. Does it have two T's or one T? Flintstones.
One T.
That was two.
They're trying to say it has two T's. That's why I said for all my old school heads.
Because
now you might remember it having two, but we remember it having it.
Die.
Just yeah.
I
was just watching.
Nah, but it's
that.
Flintstone. It wasn't
Flynn. It was Flintstones.
Flynn.
The Flintstones.
I thought it was Flintstones.
No.
I was just watching that joint.
All right, and everybody loves the book. I mean, the movie Forrest Gump, correct?
Yeah.
Now the main thing when he was talking to the lady when he had a box of
chocolate.
Okay. Now what was the statement that he said that is referred to it?
Life is like a box of chocolate.
Nope. It's now. It now says, life was like a box of chocolate.
No, that's bullshit.
Nah, see, that just fucked up my whole teenagehood, man.
Teenagehood, damn, man. Childhood, teenagehood, man.
All right, I'm gonna mess up your childhood one more time
right
because
now.
Everybody watched the movie Snow White, and this one's for the ladies too.
Oh,
right,
our Disney princess. So when she's talking to the mirror on the wall, what's the phrase she says?
Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who is the blackest of them all?
No.
Well, nah. Well, you still.
who's
still,
the finest of them all?
It's still it says magic mirror on the wall.
No.
And now your mind has been blown with Duchess SS conspiracy.
No. It's mirror, mirror on the wall.
Yep. And then that's what
to
they're
the
even
windows,
saying.
To the
that's what happened to the Mona Lisa smile. Because we remember when the Mona Lisa smile, the painting.
Yeah,
it never had a smile. But now she has like this deep smirk now. And they're like, oh, she always had that smirk. No, she didn't, if you look at it.
That is the most overpriced basic bitch I've ever seen.
And you can Google all of them and fact check me. Right?
Huh. Damn, I wish we could get this on the screen.
I know. That was a good one.
Wow. It's like, I'm really looking at this.
Mm-hmm. I remember this one. But now all I see is this one.
Yo, it's like she lost like some neck fat too around here.
She got a little makeover,
you know,
nip tuck.
Yeah,
I said,
they updated her.
The Kardashians got Mona.
How did Peyton get plastic surgery? Yeah. That's fucking crazy. I was like, damn, all these bitches getting work.
So I hope you enjoyed Dutch's Conspiracy. Shit. And I hope your mind was blown.
Because my mind is blown. God, man, that shit fucked me up.
Yep.
Damn, everything is a lie.
Exactly.
Well, yeah, most, yeah.
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 Oh.
Why am I being so surprised? For real. Damn, man, that shit's fucking crazy.
Y'all watched that movie, Hannibal Lecter, too, right?
Silence of the Lambs, yeah.
Yep, okay, so instead of it saying, hello, Clarice, they say, good morning, Clarice.
Somehow that sounds less menacing.
Yes, but he's the one that...
Yo, I swear that's my white daddy, man. I love that motherfucker,
I'm fucking
man.
Done. That's my white daddy. I'm fucking, that's my white daddy.
Shut up, man. You saw what he did to the police in the fucking cage. He fucked him up.
He said, that's my white daddy. I'm fucking
Okay, because so, this one just blew my mind. This is, has just
daddy.
Been up-to-dated. I'm so glad that I actually got the time to sit here and ask y'all. How many states is in America? I was raised that when we gained Puerto Rico, was it? That it should be 52. We always have 51. But now it's saying that, nope. Nope. We're 50 fucking one.
Again.
Yes, the correct answer is obviously 50. But I, no, wait,
51.
No. Yes.
It's 51, yeah.
I'm sorry, geography was my shit.
Yeah.
Geography was my shit.
Now, and now, Sinbad but they, never played the genie.
Bomba Clyde. Really?
What, Aladdin?
No, he never played the genie.
In Aladdin, right?
No, not in
Sinbad
Aladdin.
Sinbad was a sailor,
Aladdin,
was he not?
They said that he had a genie movie, and they're like, no, that was Shazam with Shaquille O'Neal.
Hello?
You remember that one with Shaquille O'Neal?
Yes.
Shazam.
Oh, Shazam. That's
but they're like,
trash.
No, like they're like, it was Sinbad had his own, but he's like, no, I never was in there. And then,
Sinbad, holy
this
shit.
This one killed me too. Smokey the Bear done switched up on us too.
What? Not even Smokey the Bear?
It's Smokey.
Even, damn, they got Smokey?
They got Smokey!
That, no, nobody's safe. Nobody's
they
safe.
They got Smokey!
Yo, what if they fuck with our podcast?
That's what I'm saying. It's gonna be Keep It Up.
Yeah.
Like,
or Keeping It. Or Keeping It. Keeping
oh
up
my
no.
goodness. They're gonna add
no.
an IN.
Nothing
they're
safe.
They're gonna add an IN on us.
Yeah, yo. Fuck. That's fucked up. No, no, they're gonna put an ING.
Yeah, nope, they're gonna think we're gonna be hood.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, nah, leave the G out. Leave the G out. They're
gonna
think they did.
Oh, why? Because the G in us? That's fucked up.
Waiting for the Godfather.
That's fucked up.
Mm-hmm.
Marvin's here?
Yeah, he's on his way.
All right, man, we only got 10 minutes. Mm-hmm. Where's the nigga at?
Okay.
Hurry your black ass up, Marv.
The Godfather of comedy.
Go ahead.
I made a promise. Can I do this?
Mm-hmm.
What's up?
Let me see. I made a promise that I'll play this for my brother.
A story you're about to hear is unique in the annals of American crime.
There's something happening for our young brothers who are in here. The government of America wants to turn you into snitches. It's now become snitch machines, turning out snitches every day. And when they get you in jail, what they want to do is offer you something against your brother. And as long as they can divide the community like that, you will stay divided, stay divided, stay divided.
Yeah. Yo. My mic sounds nice. Check one. Yo. Yo. Be that hardcore and make them brothers that fool. Pack guns, that funds, move work in that crew. Be that hardcore, make them brothers that fool. Pack guns, move work in the hood and that crew. Be that
that hardcore. What you got stuck up and robbed for? Got no heart for the game, then go to Job Corps. When the judge start handing you years, don't cop out and hand in your peers, cause your people ain't stared. They're prepared to come flare them things at you. The master plan is a grafted man to catch you. Perhaps you better be more clever. Your choice in getting cheddar get you dead in a box. Turn the form before the Fed and the cops. What's the difference? Either way, you better dead in a box, laying dormant. Streets keep talking, he keeps stalking. 6 feet deep, snitches sleep in cheap coffins. The seat be the code of the week, they keep offing. Keep bargains, and what you do, there's no turning back. Only time in life you'll see a dog turn to a rat. That's hardcore, to make them brothers act fool. Pack guns, stack funds, move working that cool. Be that hardcore, make them brothers act cool. Pack guns, move and work in the hood and act cool. Be that hardcore, and make them brothers act fool. Pack guns, stack funds, move drugs and act cool. Be that hardcore, make them brothers act fool. Pack guns, move and work in the hood and act cool. He was born to the world, not a product of love. His father raped his mother, passed out on drugs. Threw some pills and a drink up at the club. Woke up the next morning, panties covered in blood. And this shit happens every day. She was only 16, her mother sent her away. Couldn't afford to feed another mouth in the house. Quickly packed up her shit, told her get the fuck out. Hit the streets, sleeping from couch to couch. Till her friends got tired of her. That's when she met a new lover named Rick, who claimed that he would ride for her. Let her stay in the crib, but barely saw her. He in the streets, pushing that work for days. Ecstasy, crack, cocaine, that drove in haze. All the time her stomach's getting bigger and bigger. She felt sick, shit she got with her. With figures, till he got sent upstate. And as the water breaks, she gave birth to a boy. Same time she started smoking rock, shooting that boy. Depressed out her whole life, she wouldn't get to enjoy. She kept smoking and gave up her last breath and took to live. DCF came through when they took the kid. And he'll never get to blossom and bloom. You don't care, but one of these days he'll be robbing you soon. That's hardcore, to make them brothers act fool. Pack guns, stack funds, move working that cool. Be that hardcore, make them brothers act cool. Pack guns, move and work in the hood and act cool. Be that hardcore, make them brothers act cool. Pack guns, stack funds, move drugs and act cool. Be that hardcore, make them brothers act cool. Pack guns, move and work in the hood and act cool.
That you can ride to and everything. What is it? What's another great project? Elzai, good underground MC from Detroit that y'all should know about. For my backpackers, you know that, you know that essence hip hop, you know, super
or
nice.
Bag ladies, you know, you can put it in the purses.
Names album Seven Times Down, Eight Times Up. Go check that shit out. That shit is dope. And
I'd like to welcome you.
Education
something.
Purposes. Well, it's not really education.
Very special.
I just caught one of my favorite comedians.
Fall classic.
Rodney Dangerfield.
Ghost.
Biography, man. Go check that shit out.
Hit him.
I put on, not necessarily put on, like I'm saying, I can't stress the fact, you know, the quarantine, social distancing, the putting on of the mask, protecting yourself and others around you.
Don't be like the president.
Yeah, taking the time, you know what I'm saying, to call your loved ones. You know, let your friends and family know that you love them, you know, because you never know. Tomorrow's not promised. Yeah.
That's a fact, man.
That's just, you know, the
words
keeping
of
it a buck. Yeah.
Hey, keep it a buck message. Your word. Hold on. Oh, damn.
Exactly.
You got to pass me that. Pass me the ox, baby. Big facts. What you got, Sister Duchess?
Alrighty, so I do have a couple of put-ons. One is the one with our godfather, Marvy Marv. That's for Halloween special.
Yeah.
Yes. And I do,
that might be him.
I am going to be putting up together with a couple of moms, since we're not doing the regular trick-or-treating, you know, for the kids.
Oh, that's
me and a couple of moms are
going to
get out some goodie bags so we can throw them around at these kids.
Oh, okay.
And, you know, you can't go outside, so maybe we can come to you. So, okay. Yeah, so any mom that
social
wants to.
Social distance and everything?
Exactly.
Okay,
you know,
cool,
tossing
cool.
the bag at
oh,
you.
Oh, okay, yeah, catch it, catch it.
Like, no.
Hey, if you don't catch
your
it,
way,
okay.
stay away from me.
Exactly.
All right.
Exactly.
But yes, we'll be making up some candy bags and getting them out to some of the kids that are unfortunately, you know, it's the end of the month. It's sometimes
yeah.
harder for mothers to go out there and buy candy.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, who the hell wants to buy candy at the end of the month? No, no.
Yeah,
no.
It should be like
you
in the middle
get that
of the
thing
month.
Half off.
Word.
So yes,
you
yes,
know
yes.
majority of people are gonna get that during the week.
Like,
anyways,
what?
Just store the candy and shit.
Yes.
Alright, we got a VIP, Mr. Marvin Wells from LOL Saturday.
Yes.
Yo,
what up, everybody?
We must have said his name three times like Candyman, because he just appeared.
Yeah.
What's good, bro? What's good, man?
Is this my seat right here?
Go ahead, take a
we
seat.
Wish we could give you a throne.
Yeah. Right,
you know? How's everybody doing?
Good. I don't know how the viewers are going to feel about, you know, you kicking a black woman off her seat. You
know
what's going on. You know?
Wow.
Why no beef?
And so are we on the air now?
Yeah, we're live
yeah,
and direct
live,
right
we
now.
Live right now. We live right now. We got a couple minutes right now, so we got to make the best of it.
Marvin, please tell the viewers what exactly is LOL Saturday. And what you got going down there in Woonsocket.
Word.
All right, can somebody tell, where the hell is the camera at? So I'm
right there.
I'm looking the audience in the face. How y'all doing?
Like the Avant song, 4 minutes.
Que pasa? I got to speak a little Spanish, case some Spanish honeys. You know what I mean? Want to get with my mind. But LOL Saturdays is a unique event that we got going on where we're able to put the best of both worlds together right now. We're able to do the Zoom broadcast. And we have a small audience as well. And the reason that was important because comedians need that energy, man.
For
you
real.
Know what I mean? Like, I did a Zoom show, and it was fun. But I was home by myself with, you know, with my phone. I was in a room, and there was just no energy.
Yeah,
you know
weird.
What I mean?
Yeah.
I wasn't laughing at my own jokes and stuff
yeah,
like that.
Yeah.
You
right.
know what I mean?
Right.
So I know how important that is for comedians to hear that laughter. You know what I mean? So I really wanted to do it in a way that we can have that, but
yeah.
be safe as well. So, you know, we limit the audience to 10, 15 people.
Yeah.
We keep everyone socially distanced.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And I haven't been cleaning the mic between comedians, but Dale is going to start this weekend.
Hey, you want to squirt?
Oh, yeah, might as well.
Yeah, exactly, right? Make sure, you know, everybody's safe here.
For real.
Yeah, I'm going to give
you ain't a female asking me that question. I'm like, what you mean?
Wow.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I feel you, man. But it's good seeing you, man.
Oh, man,
yes,
it's
sir.
Good to
really
see you,
good
see
you,
brothers, man. And I'm really, like, proud of the two of you, too, man, keeping the Keep It A Buck podcast going, man.
Thank you,
yeah,
sir.
I remember
really
when y'all
grand,
first
man.
Started out. I remember y'all actually, didn't y'all do one of these at my theater?
Yeah, we did like,
yeah,
we did like
yo,
a two
yo,
years. Two
yo.
Years went fast.
And we've been meaning, you know,
it's
to
been
do a
2 years?
Yeah, 2 years went very fast.
Wow.
That was 2 years ago?
Hell yes, that was 2 years.
You know, it went by fast when I don't even remember the shit. Like,
2 years went by fast.
Now,
really
I'm bad
did.
With dates. I'm bad with dates.
Yeah.
I'm bad with dates and names.
Before That's we go, just when is the next edition of LOL Saturday? And who is on the lineup?
All right, so it's this Saturday.
Oh, this Saturday.
2020.
Another one.
Yeah, that was dope. We've got Latasha Hughes.
Oh,
yeah.
Sister. Knock one on.
Colin Felder. And for the first time coming on LOL Saturdays, my man, Mr. Maury Smith. And I know he's going to light it up.
Oh, God. Yeah.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
And we got coming all the way from Western Mass to hang out with us this Saturday. The one and only Mr. Tim Lovett. He's going to be in the house.
Love it.
Another one.
That's what's up.
And of course, this Saturday, you know,
Right.
Love hosting. You know, I've been hosting the LOL Saturdays.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But you know what? Sometimes when you're hosting, you can't really sit back and take the whole show in.
Yeah. Right.
Exactly, you know what I mean? It's because your mind's going. You got to do this.
Yeah, exactly.
So this Saturday, I'm going to sit back and I'm going to take the whole show in.
Yeah.
The air over is going to be hosting and doing this thing.
All right.
Big Brother Dale, Almighty.
Yes, sir.
Word.
Yeah. Let me tell you about the Duchess Effect. The Duchess Effect. So yes, you know Duchess headlined the last show, right?
Well,
yes.
So she put a picture up on Facebook, right?
Mm-hmm.
And everybody was commenting on her shoes. It was like, girl, the shoes are cute. Love the shoes. Love those shoes. I was like, damn, Duchess should have been on stage.
Yes.
That's what I was like.
Struck boom. Stuff, girl.
From now on, every LOL Saturday is going to be on stage. We're taking it to the next level. Hey, so Colin, wear cute shoes Saturday.
cute
shoes, bro.
I'm going to wear just my bare feet. You know how most niggas got athlete's foot? I got slavery foot.
But you know what? You know what my nickname is? And I'm going to get Twinkle Toes.
All right, man.
Women tell me I got the prettiest feet they ever seen.
My brother got the Spartacus sandals on.
Squirt, nigga.
Get the fuck out of here.
He got them Jurassic.
That's what I'm talking about. That's why I love this man.
Hey, okay, that's our time, man. We really over time. We over time this time. But this is Keep It A Buck. This is Keep It A Buck podcast, episode 97.
Yep.
Signing off. My name is Mr. F, a.k.a. The Black.
Light Skin Messiah, Jonathan Rollins. And it was up on the mic, girl.
And it's your girl, Duchess SS. So sorry.
And one more time.
And the one and only, Marvy Mar.
Yeah. And we out.
To Mrs. F on the back. Peace.
Smoke weed every day.